Hello everyone, this is Ali Raza, and in today's lecture I'm going to teach you what is encapsulation. Basically it is an object oriented pillar. In the previous lectures we have studied about what is abstraction and what are the pillars of object oriented programming and what is object oriented programming. In today's class I'm going to demonstrate about encapsulation, right? So what is encapsulation? The term we can get the idea from a capsule. When we see a capsule, we have the medicine inside that capsule, and we can say that medicine is protected inside that capsule, right? So why that medicine is protected inside that capsule? Because that medicine is so sensitive that it cannot be open in the clear environment, in an open environment. So we have to protect it inside a capsule. That's what the concept of encapsulation is inside object-oriented programming. In object-oriented programming, we can hide or wrap our data inside some other container, and that's what encapsulation is in object-oriented programming. Let's say we have a variable, and inside that I wanted to store that variable, or I wanted to wrap that variable inside a particular container. So that's what encapsulation is. The basic advantage of encapsulation is to hide or to wrap the data inside another container. Let's say if I am moving with cash inside my wallet on the road, so there are maximum chances that my wallet got stolen or theft, or it can be I can lost my wallet somewhere, so the direct loss I can face that with respect to my money. So all the cash will be taken out, or whatever will be the consequences we can face. So likewise, if I change the situation, I can, if I am moving with a credit card or a debit card with me, then what will happen? If my wallet will be lost, or it will be thrown somewhere, or it will be stolen or theft, whatever will be, my actual amount will be safe inside the bank. So that's what encapsulation is. Encapsulation works like this. You cannot access directly your variable, but instead you can access your members of the class indirectly with the help of some other members of that particular class. For that purpose, let me give you a coding example. We have studied properties. So to perform encapsulation, you have to create properties. People know that properties with the name getters and setters. So basically, with the help of properties, we can apply encapsulation. The formal definition of encapsulation can be the binding of code and data together is known as encapsulation, right? So we can bind and we can combine the data and the code together so that we can achieve the encapsulation process, right? Hopefully you have understood the whole core concept, what encapsulation is. Now let me demonstrate a little bit about what are properties so that you can apply and use that concept inside your software. So create a software and create some properties. You noticed then when you create a property, you have the type of properties, basically the read-write property, the read-only property, and the write-only property. And when you create a property, you have to specify some conditions in that, and based on that conditions, you pass your data via your to your hidden members of that particular class. So if you wanted to practically apply encapsulation inside your software, so go to my C# playlist and look for encapsulation lectures inside that C# playlist, and you can find it also in Java if you are a Java developer. Okay, so do try these all. I will be back with some other concept of object oriented programming in the next lecture. Hopefully you have understood everything. Thank you so much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.